hilarious as hell.
So we're recording now. You know?
Yeah.
So hi guys. This is Mary. Hi, this is Mary. You are watching the Life of Mary podcast, where you will hopefully get a podcast with one of my friends, hopefully once or twice, and for a separate video by myself. If you want to be a guest on the podcast, please check me out on Twitter, or also known as X, as Mary20S23, or email me at mary.lauren.1919@gmail.com if you want to be a guest. Tonight's guest is one of my friends from Twitter, James. Twitter tag will also be in the tag file, so if you want to follow him there, James there, please do. You can check James there out. You can check them out at James16James, right?
Yep.
See? I do my... I literally did this for you. So, over the past few episodes, I got an opportunity, which I'm glad about. This recently happened after the first episode, but if you want to get anything from turtle pendant necklaces, tumblers of all sorts, bracelets of all sorts as well, rosaries, long eyelashes, chapsticks of scents such as mint, cherry, watermelon, orange, lily of the valley, pineapple, apple, grape, rose, coconut, strawberry, mango, vanilla, and peach. Also in their shop is beautiful quartz serpentine, a quartz haze figurine, I think it was horses last time I checked, pens that are decorated, dice. Which are transparent, wire wrapped chakra, so chakra colors in a wire, in like a rose quartz, it's really pretty, selenite wood, halite pendant, cross pendants, and facial rollers, and finally glass skulls, which were low on stock. I don't know if she's going to re-upload them. They just posted where you can also get custom tumblers. They are all on my friend's website, which will be linked in the bio. You can get 15% off by using my code, which is Mary, in all capitals, she said, 15. Again, for 15% off, the code will be written out in the bio. She recently just said most of her things are $13 for tumblers, and they are handmade. She is gladly reposting this on her website, my whole channel. I'm happy to say this. But you guys will hear later on that a little later, but Packers fan Tom Grossi won Packers fan of the year. Please vote for him to win NFL fan of the year. He raised $500,000 for St. Jude, does a lot of charity work. He recently went to all of the NFL stadiums in 30 days. So please give him a vote if any of your email accounts link will be in the bio. How he is in his videos is in the real person and mine in real life. You can also vote as many times as you want to. I believe voting ends early December. First part. So far, we've been recording for 3 minutes, just so you know.
Yeah.
This is not a question, but please let the audience know a little bit about yourself.
I'm real simple. Big Packers fan, is, if you follow me, you know I am. I'm one of the biggest. I love to cook, although I have not done it in so long. It used to be one of my favorite hobbies. But if you follow me on TikTok, you know what I love to do most. I can get down to Michael Jackson like anybody, like nobody's business. I'm like up here, everybody else like shit. Just don't say that.
Is that it?
Yeah, that's pretty much about me.
Okay, Well, I didn't know if you were going to get into your disability or anything. So, mental health wise. It's up to you.
I mean, if you like ask me questions about my autism, I can kind of, because I mean, I know what I struggled with.
Right.
So I mean, it's, you know.
Right.
It's not that big a deal.
Right. I just didn't know if you wanted to talk about it or anything.
Yeah, no, that's okay.
So this is from Justin from Twitter. All these questions are from Twitter or myself. What is your favorite experience at Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin? Besides, like, meeting Jordan Love's mom, because we will get there in a little bit.
Oh, no, I met her at the Bears game. That was a soldier.
Right. Right. But what was your favorite experience at Lambeau Field, if you have ever been to Lambeau?
Oh, I went to the Packers-Bears game last year at Lambeau.
How was it?
Oh, how was it? It was awesome. My parents surprised me. That was a birthday present.
Aww.
And that was and I'm so glad that was the time I got to see Aaron Rodgers play.
Your last time? Well,
well this was the first and last time.
Oh, wow. I didn't realize that. That's crazy.
I bet
you're excited for Jordan Love.
I always told my mom, I was like, look, whenever Rodgers leaves, if he leaves, which he ended up doing, before he leaves, I want to see him one time at Lambeau. My parents said we'll make it happen, and they did.
That is one thing I have not experienced yet, is that Lambeau or anything.
A very interesting game, actually. Especially at night, is, I mean, the whole stadium was electric from start to finish.
Right. Like, I've been to concerts, but that's it.
You gotta go to a game.
I know. I need to. I want to go when Justin and I were actually just talking about this. We're talking about going to the Jaguars game next year in Jacksonville, but I don't think we're doing it, unfortunately.
No.
Just because we're saving up money for the draft coming to Lambeau soon, which we're going to talk about actually in a little bit. Because we're both flying up there with our parents, so we're saving money as much as possible.
Smart move.
So we were just talking about this topic, actually, kind of. What was it like to talk to Jordan Love's mom at the Packers against the Bears game week one in Chicago? From Justin and I actually noticed you on the TV. We were like, this is our friend from Twitter.
Everybody noticed me. Good Lord.
So what was it like meeting her for the first time?
Funny thing is, I didn't even know it was her until one of my good friends, shout out to my buddy Zach, He was the first one they called me, and I couldn't hear him. And then I got like 60, 70 text messages saying, "Hey man, we just saw you on TV," and I had no idea. And I turned to my mom and I was like, "Hey, did you get a text from so and so saying that we on television?" And she said, we were stunned. I didn't know it was Jordan Love's mother until people were telling me the whole time. And then she didn't introduce herself.
Right. So when Justin and I were watching that game, we were like, that's Jordan Love's mom next to you. One of us should have texted you.
Oh no, believe me, people had me called. No, it's good. You're good. Look, I had so many people telling me
that you were sitting next to her?
Mm-hmm. And I tell you, she could cheer with, like, she's a premium Packers fan.
Right.
Man.
She deserves it.
She was just so awesome to be with. I mean, look, my mom hated her because, I mean, we were screaming the whole time.
Right.
But, you know.
I'm sure she was excited to see her son get his first, like, official NFL touchdown.
First win.
Right. And the first official touchdown.
Yep.
Like, in his starting career. As a Green Bay Packer. Because she stopped believing me.
I was into it the whole time.
Yeah, I bet you were.
I mean, although I was on my phone a little bit here and there, that's because y'all was blowing me up.
Not my fault. I was with Justin.
Like, so many people were telling me, dude, we saw you on TV, and I tried to keep up and tried to respond to people. But they was like, get off your phone, man, enjoy the game, and I did.
I know some of us are coming up from Florida and other states and over the country from other countries.
I'm gonna try to make it. I'm gonna really try to. I mean, I went to the draft when it was here in Chicago.
Oh, wait, so you live in Chicago?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna have to text you about that because I'm actually going to Illinois soon, I think. So we might meet in person.
Alright.
Because I have family that lives in Illinois. Like, not yeah. Area. So. I'll have to hit you up.
Alright.
I did not spoil that. So, you might have an answer to this one, and I'm scared of what you're going to say. This is number 4 on the list. If I could have any guest on the podcast, who would it be and why? That person slash people, preferably on Twitter. We tried mostly every single player. And they're either verified or I can't DM. When I say we, I mean Justin helped.
Oh, no.
Like, we tried to get Brian Bulaga, couldn't do it. AJ Hawk, Clay Matthews, Aaron Jones.
Damn, we tried everybody.
We literally went through the whole roster and couldn't DM them. It's either couldn't DM or it wasn't verified. I don't have a verified account, so. So, speaking of that, who would you want to see on the podcast if I could? And why that person? Why that person slash people? It can be, like, 2 people as well. I don't care anymore.
You know, as crazy as this sounds, you ought to try getting Coach on.
Not before? Wait, Matt LaFleur? Is that who we're talking about?
Yep.
I don't know how I would contact them. I mean, but he does have Twitter. Uh-oh. He might have a good idea. Uh-oh. Now I'm even more scared. Okay.
Hey, my advice to you is just, look, just go for it.
Yeah, and Justin and I actually, I actually found a former Packer from the 2017 team and a Badgers player at the same time on Twitter. And I said DM him, so.
That's how I'm saying. You never know unless you try.
Right. And that's the thing is, like, I'm trying. Like, I'm going to try Kurt Benkert. I could DM him. He has a verified account. I could DM him to hear why the Packers wouldn't kick him off or whatever. Like, more in depth. I know he kind of mentioned it. Speaking of that, what is your opinion about that, if you heard about that?
I don't think I heard that.
It was something about Coach Matt LaFleur.
What was up?
I don't know the full story, but I can send it to you.
Alright.
Because I saw it and I was like, wait, what?
Because, yeah, I don't think I heard about it.
So, if Kurt had a chance, would you like him to come back to Green Bay? Like, as a former quarterback?
Oh, yeah.
Help for Jordan Love.
Yeah. Look, he needs all the help he can get.
Yeah. We're going to talk about Jordan Love in a little bit, as you know. Number 5 is, what are your division predictions from all of the NFL divisions? I know when Emily and I did this question, we had a Google link. So hopefully you know it.
Well, I can tell you right now, I got the NFC North completely wrong.
Oh no, who did you say?
I had Minnesota finishing first.
Oh, that's weird. Emily said the Packers.
This was before the season started.
Right.
I have
Minnesota.
Okay, so as of now, Detroit's run away with it.
Yeah. How about for AFC North?
You know, I love what Baltimore's doing. I really do. I told a few friends of mine, I was like, look, they may be the best team in football right now. Mm-hmm. So I'm going with them.
Ravens?
Yeah.
I think Emily went with them, too. I went with Browns originally, because I like their defense, but I just like what Za'Darius Smith has to do with the Ravens, or Browns this year. He's good on their defense team. NFC East.
Eagles.
That's a popular one.
That was too easy.
AFC East.
Bills.
Oh, I think a lot of people had Dolphins. NFC West. Most people have 49ers for this one.
I did.
You did? Did you, speaking of 49ers and Rams and that whole division, Carson Wentz being a Rams quarterback, thoughts on that?
The Rams just love getting recycled quarterbacks, don't they?
Yeah, I think Justin and I literally tweeted each other when we saw that. We think the Packers broke Ripon.
Oh, yeah.
And then he just signed with the Seahawks. AFC West.
Chiefs.
Okay, I can do that.
And by the way, I do rank for the city, by the way.
Yeah, I saw that on Twitter. Yep. Or X, whatever it's called now. NFC South.
Who's Lord? Oh, Jesus. That damn division gives me a headache.
Yeah.
I want to go to New Orleans so bad, but I mean, that division is pitiful.
We know
the Panthers ain't. Panthers ain't gonna do nothing. We know they're not gonna do nothing. Fuck them out.
Bucks or Falcons.
I'm going with the. Skip it. I really can't.
Oh, decide. Wait. Okay.
I really can't decide.
AFC South.
Jacksonville.
Good thing you actually knew that one, because that's one that Emily and I had to look up on Google. Is that the one? So that's also post Michael Thomas's arrest today. I don't know if you saw that.
Oh, I did.
Yeah. It's a silly mistake, but
I tell you a crazy thing. I had him in one of my fantasy football leagues. This was like we do a dynasty league, which is pretty much where we draft players and we get to keep them year after year after year.
Mm-hmm.
I traded him away at the beginning of last year for
my God.
I can't remember who, but it was the best decision I ever made.
Yeah. So now you don't have him?
No.
I feel bad for whoever has him and Kirk Cousins this year and Aaron Rodgers, like from the start.
Oh.
I feel so bad. And like Daniel Jones is another one. Justin and I noticed all 8 are getting injured. Daniel Jones, Aaron Rodgers, Kirk Cousins. Packers have a number 8 quarterback. Hope we don't start him.
I know I should be bad, but that's funny.
No, it's okay. But Justin and I noticed both Packers have a number 8 quarterback.
Oh.
Sean Clifford. So, this is going to be scary if he has to start. What is one thing on your bucket list that you want to do eventually?
Go to Hollywood.
Ooh. Wait, any specific reason? Or just a visit?
Just a visit. And I got a friend out there who lives in Los Angeles.
Wow. You can make your answers a little bit longer if we're trying to beat the first episode, like I told you about.
Yeah.
Because we're on 7 out of 20. We have a lot still to go. These mates might be longer answers to anyways.
But yeah, I got an old friend named Michelle who I'm really close to.
She went and to they school. Live in Hollywood?
Yeah, no, she
They're close
she
to
went,
it.
Went to school out in, I think it was UC Berkeley? I can't remember exactly, but she's lived out there for the last like 4 or 5 years, and God, the lifestyle out there is just, it's dope. I've always wanted to go to Hollywood.
Yeah. Always. I've always wanted to like visit Disneyland. It's always been on my bucket list.
What, the Hollywood Walk of Fame is out there?
Like the stars.
Yeah.
The stars of fame or whatever. I want to like walk on that to like all the Disney parks.
Yeah.
And go to Lambeau, like eventually.
Well, I crossed it off my bucket list. That was actually the second time I went. I actually went for the very first time I went,
mm-hmm.
summer trip that I took. That was in, that was my 8th grade graduation gift.
Oh, wow.
That was the first time I went with my parents and I toured Lambeau.
Yeah, like, I've seen Lambeau, but, like, I haven't been inside of it.
Oh, God. Like, the history when you walk in there.
Yeah.
I can't explain it. It's just,
yeah.
It's breathtaking.
Yeah.
Like, from the moment you step into the stadium, they got banners everywhere of former
yeah.
players
mm-hmm.
and coaches. I mean, it's just...
Right.
Oh. You're gonna... Whenever you decide to go...
I think it's gonna be the draft. It's
you're gonna
draft.
Love it. You
think
gotta
it's gonna
go
be
to
the
a,
draft.
We're going to a game, though. That's
yeah.
a totally different level.
Yeah, I'm training. Yeah, that's definitely like on my bucket list. Has to go to a game.
You've got to.
Like, I've seen Raymond James Stadium, and Miami is up and close, and Baltimore's, but like, haven't been to their stadiums. Like, haven't been inside.
Yeah, I went to Soldier Field too, and
right.
Yeah.
How was it? Is it as bad as people say?
Yeah, my mom hated it too.
Interesting. Okay.
Well, no, because, like, the thing is, we had to walk quite a ways just to get there. We didn't really drive down. We took a cab all the way down to Soldier Field.
Right. Oh, right. So you live in that area. Makes sense.
Yeah. So, I mean, we had to walk a mile from the stadium to the, just to catch a cab to go to the train station. It was, brutal.
So you're going to hate this question the most, and I'm sorry. I don't remember who wrote this one. I think I did, actually. My bad. Already. what's one thing that you would want to change for this year's Packers? One thing.
Give it to Brian Gutekunst, please.
Wait, why do you say that?
He gets on my damn nerves. I don't know what the hell he's doing with this team.
Yeah.
Like, I get trying to go young and try to build up these young rookies. And believe me, some of these guys that he's drafted over the years, they're studs. Quay Walker.
Yeah.
I think Dobbs can be that if he can stay healthy. Musgrave.
Watson.
Yeah, I love Watson.
Yeah, I love Watson too. I think he's injury prone for sure.
Yeah.
And that doesn't help.
Huh. And it's just, you know, it's... The one thing that disturbs me most, though,
mm-hmm.
lack of discipline with this team.
Agreed.
Like, ain't no, like, this ain't college no more.
Right.
Y'all a grown man. Y'all got a job to do.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the same repeat of mistakes week after week after week.
Right. Run the damn ball.
That fall, well, no, forget that. Just the penalties are
mm-hmm.
maddening. And it's just, yep. you know, something needs to, you know, if Good wasn't my first choice, I mean, Joe Barry's obviously the popular choice.
right?
Matt LaFleur's got to go, though.
Interesting, okay. Even though he just signed a contract with them and Good.
I'm starting to get sick of LaFleur, man. He's just, he can't get out of
okay,
his own
you're
way.
Gonna love eight.
He can't get out of his own
love-
way.
You're gonna love number 8 then.
Yeah,
what coaches should be fired and should replace them on the Packers? So
yeah,
who would you fire and who would replace them?
Yeah, I'm getting rid of LaFleur, man. I just
know all the coaches if you had a chance, like Barry, LaFleur, Gutekunst. Who would replace them in their place?
I don't know who the hell will replace him. That is a good. That is a good question. I really. Yeah, you got me on that one. I really don't know. But it's just that I just think this whole front office needs to change from top to bottom.
Yeah.
And I'm sure I'm not the only I'm not the only fan that feels the same way.
No, you're not. Well, I'll tell you something after this that I can tell you that you're gonna laugh. It's about one of my shirts that someone wants me to make.
Uh-oh.
No, it's good. It's funny, but he told me not to make it for him, which I'm debating on now. So I saw from your Twitter you were a Lakers fan, so I'm wondering, how did you become a Lakers fan knowing you're from Chicago? Or around the Chicago area.
Biggest LeBron fan.
Makes sense.
That's my too.
Makes sense. Okay, so we kind of talked about this person earlier, but what are at least two questions you have for a January's guest? And I'm only saying January's guest because I don't think we're going to have a December guest. Unless that's a price to change. I don't think we will, though. It might just take off. I don't know yet. Actually, December, we'll have a video of the 30 and 30 behind the scenes from Tom Crossing. Is what I'm going to do. So, what are at least two questions you have for January's guest? And you already know who January's guest is.
Yep.
You can also text me these if you want.
I would say...
This person has been to Lambeau.
I was going to say, how did he become a Packers fan? And
I already know that. But I can ask. No, I can ask. Okay.
Alright, then. And, I got one about me, actually.
Yeah. I'm pretty much done, so.
What makes me... what makes me a good friend? Like, what in his opinion... draws me to people.
Oh, good.
Okay. And I'll actually ask you that too.
Oh, great. I think your personality is what makes you a great friend. And actually, so I think I can say this. Yeah. So when I got in the car accident last year, you are one of the first people that reached out to me.
Actually. Was that?
Yeah. You and my friend Charles, the birthday twin. And Justin, obviously. You guys were one of the three in the mar. A lot of people reached out to me that day, and you guys, kept me comfortable, kept me relaxed and everything with what went on. And your, friendliness. I know you and I have talked about multiple things. You guys are all open to me. As I mentioned in the, tweet, in the thankfulness tweet, which... I can pretty much say I did now to everyone because everyone knows I did it. So I did write that 1 for you 5, and it means what I wrote is true. And I had another person reach out to me that said it was all true for you guys as well.
That's good to know.
I'm not gonna say the other person's name, but I had another person reach out to me as that's true for you guys as well.
You can just text and tell me.
Wait, what?
The you questions? Said another other person.
Oh. You want me to tell you who it is?
Yeah, you can do that. Okay. Bye.
Yeah, I will. I'm not gonna. Yeah. So, this is a fun question that I've had a really good answer for in the past. So what is a podcast that you would like to be on if you had a chance besides for this one?
I was on Packers Without Borders.
Oh, were you? It's so funny.
I'm gonna send you the episode as soon as we're done.
Please do. Okay. I was on Hey We Like Your Pod. So that was my first experience about podcast. Is that one? It's kind of funny.
Yeah, I'm gonna send you that, and I also was on. I was on ESPN Milwaukee the Monday after the Packers game, the Packers Bears game that I went to, because they reached out to me and said, "Hey man, we saw you all the place." Did I ever send you that?
No.
I'm gonna send you that interview. You'll love it.
Yeah, because now I'm interested. Well, what they said.
You'll love it.
Yeah, like I said, I was on. Packet it. No, not Packet it. I wish I was on Packet it. Andy Herman is like one of my tunes again. That was one of the best days ever. I was on Hey We Like Your Pod recently. Not recently. Like a month ago. It was fun. I can send you a link if you want.
Please do.
You should be on their podcast.
Who is it?
Hey We Like Your Pod with Dawn and Matt.
Okay.
They have Twitter. They film on Thursdays is the issue with that one. At night, like during halftime. While there's nothing going on.
Okay, I'll look them up.
Because you just have to pretty much DM them on Twitter. Be like, hey, I want to be on your podcast. Schedule me or something like that. It's pretty simple. That's all I did. Okay, I might hate this question. From a Twitter account that a lot of people don't like. If we could have a former player on the current Packers not naming Aaron Rodgers or Brett Favre, who would it be and why that person? This is a spinoff of Packers Ike question. I know a lot of people don't like that account.
I would say
a former, not like current.
I would say Charles Woodson.
Good answer, even though he was rooting for the Raiders against the Packers and Raiders game.
Yeah.
Sadly.
I love Charles, man. He was one hell of a lead. He was one hell of a player for us.
Well, I don't want to ask 13. We're going to skip 13 till the, like, one of the last questions. Because that one makes me sad. For obvious reasons. So this is a spinoff of Brian Bulaga, Spooky of Brian Bulaga. Do you think we have a pack? Do you think the Packers have a top 5 offensive linemen? If so, what's the order for this year's Packers in specific? This includes like injured players, because I know Bakhtiari is injured right now. So.
He's our best one.
Yep.
I'm gonna say Bakhtiari. I know for a fact. Myers and Newman are probably dead.
Yeah. I think they're gonna get traded personally.
I don't like either of them.
Me neither.
Yeah. I like Yael Schneider too.
Mm-hmm.
And there's another guy that we all like, but he doesn't get much playing time either. It's probably
Ryan.
It's probably him, now that I think about it.
Ryan played last week when John Runyan was out. I like Ryan.
I love Brian.
No, Ryan. Ryan. Ryan.
Yeah, okay, yeah, I know who you're talking
about. I like
about.
Him. Yeah. I like Zach Tom, too. I don't know. I also like Elton. Elton's good.
Jenkins would probably be second for me.
Okay. And what positions? Like, obviously, Bakhtiari's left tackle. But.
Jenkins is right tackle?
He plays left guard currently. I didn't know if he would change that or anything.
Okay.
Center. Zach Tom can play center. Who else?
Yeah, man, I can't, man.
That's hard.
They make my head hurt.
We can move on to that question. So you think we do have a top 5 offensive line then?
That's a really hard.
Besides Josh Myers and Royce Newman. Besides those two.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts of Tom Grossi winning Fan of the Year for the Packers? I know a lot of people said they should be someone else. What are your thoughts about Tom Grossi winning?
Yeah, I was okay with it. I mean, it's, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, there are a million of us out here.
Right.
Yo, I'm surprised.
I think of all of us, I think Tom deserves it the most.
He's a cool
From what I said earlier and other things. He's been a Packer fan since he was 6 years old. 6 years old? 6 years old. He's from New York. He has a phenomenal podcast. What?
That's awesome.
Yeah, he said that in the Twitter video, which I will not play because copyright. He said that in the Twitter video. He's been a Packer fan since he was 4 years old, 6 years old. I keep forgetting on how old. Yeah, but he's, like I said before, he's raised $500,000 from St. Jude. His first stop was at Lambeau Field, thankfully. And he ended it, I believe, with Rams Chargers, I think. 49ers. I don't know. I think it was 49ers, now that I think about it. He started it with the Packers and he ended it with the 49ers. So it was a fun, yeah. That's actually when Justin and I met him, which is my Twitter profile. Which I think was, I think that's it. I don't know. It's definitely my Twitter profile name now, though. He's phenomenal. A phenomenal person. I don't know. We're getting shorter on questions. Uh-oh. One of my last ones might be longer, though. Actually, I know one of them will be longer. Any player you want to meet and why? I know you're making me answer this one. So, any player you want to meet and why?
Well, I did meet Amon Green last year.
Really?
I did. I met him at the Packers tailgate.
Oh, okay.
I think I still got all the pictures of it, too.
Nice. You're gonna hate these texts too.
I know people ain't gonna like this answer.
Say it.
Rodgers. That's my dude.
Yeah.
Say what you will about him off the field. I think he was the greatest. I think he's one of the greatest Packers to have ever played for us.
No, I 100% agree.
I love the man.
So you would want to meet Rodgers?
Yes.
Okay. I didn't know if I caught that right. Yeah, that's a good answer. I should have added him to the list of 10. Dang it. I have no quarterbacks, sadly. Yeah, because I took out the quarterback that I had on there. You're going to hate this next question. So, what are your thoughts on Jill Barry and Jordan Love? I know you already talked about this one. This was from Amar. From Twitter. I know we already talked about it before.
Damn it, can I be defensive coordinator? Boy, this man get on my damn nerves. He needs to be shipped to the moon.
Ooh.
Need to be far, far away from this planet. Just ship him somewhere.
And Jordan Love is part of that question as well.
Jordan, I'm willing to give him a minute. I'm not giving up on him like a lot of other people have.
I think Jordan needs another year.
It's not, let me tell you something. It's not his fault he got drafted where he could draft him. Too many people are misdirecting their anger. It shouldn't be at him. It should be at Matt LaFleur, Brian Gutekunst.
I think it's more Brian Gutekunst more than Matt LaFleur. I 100% agree.
He's the one that made the decision.
Mm-hmm.
Granted, you know, this is his first season, and it's been
right.
Very up and down.
You're right.
But
so, speaking of Packers, you might hate this one. What are your thoughts about Mike Murphy?
Oh, Lord, he needs to go, too. I'm sick of him.
So, who would be Packers president? Because currently Packers are the only team that no one can buy.
See, this is what that's another thing I hope changes one day. We need actual ownership.
Oh, like not like our owners? Just like an actual owner.
Yeah, we need somebody to run this team. I get the tradition and all that, but man, we haven't won a Super Bowl in 12 years.
12 years? Oh, God, yeah.
You know, it's time to be out with the old. Mm-hmm. You know, just. You know, get somebody that can really run this team.
100% agree.
Like, I like the shareholder stuff, but man,
I love the shareholder aspect of the team, but
it's time for that to go. It's got to be
it's time. It's time. Unfortunately.
I mean, I know that might not be a popular opinion, but that's just me.
No, I 100% agree. And I'm sure a lot of other people would as well, if they switch over if they want. How would you see the team play out? And the most surprising player, again, for Mama.
Most surprising player?
And how do you see the team play out?
Well, I don't see us doing much at all this year.
So you don't think wild card playoffs?
I had us as a wild card.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
Yeah.
Right, to start the season, but not now.
I had us going 9-8, but I don't think that's going to happen. And I'm disappointed.
Yeah. Most surprising player?
In a good way or a bad way?
How about both?
Bad way, Jair.
Oh. Oh. Look, okay.
Trump's been hurt.
Right.
But man, when you get the contract you got from them.
My bad.
You know, the main focal point. Again, injuries aside, that man been getting fried like a been getting fried like a chicken.
Yeah. I agree.
Like, nobody's scared of him.
Besides the Rams.
Exactly.
For Kropp couldn't do anything. Yeah. So, what about a good surprising player?
I like the, there's another kid on defense that I really, really do like. I think he's,
What position?
He's linebacker. He's Devondre Campbell. Either Campbell.
Speaking of that, we're about to talk about him big time.
Either Campbell or... damn it. You know what? I just thought of another name. Scratch that.
Okay.
Kenny Clark.
Yeah. He's playing. No, he's questionable. Never mind. I was about to say he's playing against the Steelers, but he's questionable, unfortunately.
Clark is one of the few defensive leaders we have.
Kenny Clark played, as you guys know.
I don't want to ask this question because I don't know if you saw. Uh-oh. I'm even more scared. What was your reaction to the Packers trading away Rasul Douglas to the Buffalo Bills for a third round pick?
I have to ask this question. I'm sorry.
I can't really say what I want to say. You know how a comedian comes up with a joke and they, you know, in today's climate, they can't, you know, they say they can't say it? I can't really say what I want to say about that. But I'm just going to put it this way. Damn you, Brian Gutekunst.
Oh. Hopefully this is better. Hopefully.
I was so mad. I had steam coming out of my ears. Especially since he said, you know, we're not going to make any trades. And then he's going, that's an offer you can't refuse.
Right. The third round pick out of everything. Like, what?
And we still get third rounders.
Exactly. Well, Sean Ryan is a third rounder. Tucker Kraft. Which we don't know about Tucker Kraft yet. I don't want to ask this question.
What you got?
I'm forced to. What is your game prediction /stats/statistics about the Steelers game tomorrow? I don't really want to ask this question, but I'm forced to.
But people don't hate me.
I'm not forced to.
Give me pick Pittsburgh. We've had such a hard time this year defensively. It's been such a disappointment. I really can't put statistics on it.
Understandable.
I just see us losing. And I hate saying that.
I have a feeling too. But so far the Packers on the podcast are 0-1. So, let's change that. I don't want this podcast to be the one to be the reason why we lose. At all.
Well, just keep your fingers crossed.
I mean, usually the Packers kept listening to me in the past. So, Packers could win. I mean, so I can talk about this. So, my friend Pack Attack tomorrow on here, him and I actually had a bet last game, and I actually won the bet.
Okay.
Was if the Packers won, I had to take a picture of myself in Packers gear, kind of send it to whatever, Packers earrings, whatever. And if we lost, which luckily we didn't, he would have to choose something for me to do, and he didn't tell me what we I have to do if we lost. So, I'm probably not going to make it about this game. Knowing that aspect of the whole thing. Oh, man. So, we're going to get back to this. Actually, we can probably end with this one, because this one's probably going to So as we said before, you want to be the 10 Packers I went to meet. Why? So do we decide if we're doing this from the most likely to not likely, or just go down the list of the time?
Just go down the list.
So I'm probably going to do two last, because of the reason for today, because it's Veterans Day. So happy Veterans Day to everyone. Okay, one. Sammy Watkins, who tried out with the Colts. I don't know if he signed with them. I was so happy. I was one of the Packer fans that wanted to keep Sammy Watkins. A lot of people said trade him away. I wanted him. I know, but I wanted him for a personal reason. So I actually met one of his family members last season, which was fun for me. That's who I was telling you about last season. I could actually break injury news last season from said family member, which I'm sad I didn't know, not knowing he's a Packer fan. Also, where he went to high school is close to me. So if you Google his hometown, that's where I live now in Florida. Not that part, but it's a fun fact. And yeah, Sammy Watkins, and it's actually funny because said family member was going to give me Dolphins tickets to the Packers game, Packers and Dolphins game in Miami last year. The one where Justin got to go to, and I was at home.
Oh.
Like, there is way. But Sammy didn't make the team, obviously, for that game. Otherwise, I probably would have gone to that game. Even if it's home game, I would have got the players' tickets. To that game. So I'm not gonna say like the player's name, the player's family name, but I did meet a family member of his. And people have asked me in the past if his family is as nice as him. Yes, they extremely as nice as Sammy is. Okay. Lucas Benness. Thank you. This is a joke on Twitter. When the Packers drafted him, I popped like a little bunny rabbit. Also, when I did my mock drafts, I got him every time I tried to do a mock draft, and so far I've been getting a player that the Packers have picked, which is kind of fun. For Anthony Luke, he plays Canadian, or he used to play, I don't know if he still does. He played for Montreal Football in Canada, Canada. He was number 45. He liked one of my, So, basically, I went to SeaWorld 4th, 4th of July in Austin, San Antonio, Texas, about 3 years ago, I think. He liked my picture on Instagram, so that was fun.
That's cool.
So, I just want to thank him for that.
I will also say, you just made me think of another name. I want to meet Christian Watson, man.
That's a good one.
Yeah, cause it, like, cause it, his mom is really cool too.
I want to have his mom on, but that's like another verified account. Like, I don't trust that.
She follows me on Instagram, so.
What the heck? I want to get her on. I feel like that would be fun.
We were talking for a minute, like, we want to try to make something happen, and I hope that we can probably arrange something.
I was about to say, you should tell her to follow me on Twitter so I can get her on the podcast, and then you can be on a guest or something with it.
I'll see what I can do. I can maybe pull some string.
If that works, that would be fantastic. Unfortunately, I have to talk about this. Ladarius Hamilton, he was a former Packer. Some of these are former Packers.
I feel like I've heard his name. Wait, Ladarius.
You have. He played last year and part of this year. He was on practice squad for us for a while. He used to go, I don't know if he still does, he used to go on Instagram Live a lot. And one of the Instagram Lives, he waved to me. And I took a picture of it on my phone. And he also liked one of my comments that I wrote. I think I wrote, like, welcome to Green Bay, like I usually do, for all the draft picks. And he actually liked that post, which was fun. So thank you again. I'll probably tag all these players eventually. AJ Dillon, how do you feel about him? I know people wanted him to get traded. That's not one of the questions.
I tell you, man, he seems like a fun kid, but man, I didn't like the draft pick.
Oh, interesting.
I didn't like that we picked him.
I
mean, if you got any, like, questions you can think of off the top of your head, I can pretty much answer them.
We still have 5 left of mine. I was just, didn't know if you had any more. So, AJ Dillon, he liked one of my tweets from last year that said something about Halloween. I think it was like, is it too early to dress up as Halloween characters or watch Halloween movies? And I said, no, never. And he liked that, so I just wanted to thank him. Raleigh Texada, he was a quarterback for the Packers. I don't remember what season, but he was recently a quarterback for the Packers. Raleigh has a private Instagram account, and he actually accepted my follow request, so that was kind of fun, knowing that you got the follow request accepted, approved by a Packer player, former Packer player. That was cool. Speaking of Devondre Campbell, let's go to Jair, and then we'll do Devondre.
Oh, I remember Rashawn. I was thinking of Rashawn Gary.
Yeah.
Although he and
Campbell. How do you think about the contract?
Well deserved.
Agreed.
You talking about the Bears? You talking about Rashawn Gary, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then the Bears destroyed it. And then the Bears sadly destroyed it big time. By signing, whoever they signed. That player, you know. I don't remember his name right now.
You talking about Robert Tonyan?
No, I knew about that one. Not Lewis. No, they traded him for him.
Sweat.
Montavious Sweat. That's what
we have. Montez Sweat, yep.
Yeah. We're not going to talk about that contract, because that's amazing. Amazing for him, but not for the Bears. Because it's never good for the Bears. Jair Alexander. I had trouble thinking of him. So, I just love his personality off the field. Not on the field. Because, I know, we know how he's like out in the field. And I would love to do yoga with him one day. I'm like big about yoga. So I just want to do that with him one day.
I bought his jersey when I went up to Lambeau.
Also to talk about how amazing he is as a cornerback. Well, I wrote that before you said your answer. Sorry, Jair. But I also want to, like, thank him
That took some guts to do. Oh yeah, I'm watching, yeah. Wait, oh.
My God! My
we
God.
Might have a roadblock.
No! I'm joking! I don't watch Pokemon.
That's what I'm saying, man. You talking to a diehard Bama fan.
Wait, so Chelsea.
Your reaction. I mean, I'm just watching from just cuz.
Right. No, I just don't watch college football. Or NFL football.
I watch college football every Saturday.
So yeah, I start watching college football when draft is around. Do I end with Aaron Jones or Russell Douglas? Probably Aaron Jones. No, probably all end with Russell Douglas, speaking of him. Aaron Jones. Aaron and I have a connection based on the military. Both our parents are from the military or in the military. So I would just love to talk to him more about that. It's interesting if you think about it in an interesting way. So, Aaron Jones, I know I'll tag you, but I would love to have you on the show to discuss that eventually. I love how he says yes, sir, and yes, ma'am, because I tend to do that sometimes. Some people have heard me say it in the past. I've said yes, ma'am, to teachers.
That's old school way to do it.
Yeah, it's just like my parents are retired from the military, so it's and I know Aaron Jones as well, like his parents, military. So that's where him and I have a huge connection.
Yeah, speaking of, my older brother was, that's the hard part. My older brother was in the military for 20 years. Served in the Navy.
Nah, it's alright, I can do it.
Yeah, he was in the military for 20 years. I loved him dearly. And, of course, if you follow me, you knew. You guys probably know what happened, but I mean, it was 2 years ago, he ended up passing away. I won't say because of what, but.
Yeah, probably shouldn't.
It was such a. It was so devastating. And it still is. I miss him every day.
Aw, dang it. Okay, we're gonna end this on a happy note. Last player is Russell Douglas. I know I told you the story.
Yeah.
So we're gonna end this on a happy note, and we actually beat the first podcast by 5 minutes, which is good. So exactly on June 12th of this year, I publicly posted something on my Twitter that account that says, can you please wish KLA happy
funeral? Okay.
Can you please wish me a late happy birthday to my twin and I. Happy birthday. I don't know what I wrote. We wanted one of the players mentioned, and we mentioned AJ Dillon, Lucas Musgrave, and Russell. Or no, AJ Dillon, Keyshawn Nixon, and Russell. Only Russell responded. So he's one of my favorite players because of that. And thankfully, Rasul commented saying, happy belated, wish you guys many more years. And I have this picture on my phone for this memory. So sadly, he's on the Buffalo Bills, and I just wanted to say thank you, Rasul. That's one of my most players I wanted to meet, and why.
That's awesome that he did that.
Yeah, I'm so grateful that he did that. Okay.